Hello everybody. Now I will want to show you how to find the upper bound and lower bound of a combination of two variables a minus b. Well, to find the lower and the upper bounds of a minus b, first of all, you will have to write down the upper and the lower bounds of a and b. So in this case, the lower bound of a is 4.5 and the upper bound of a is 5.5. Similarly, your b will have a lower bound of 2.5 and an upper bound of 3.5. And in order for you to get the upper bound of a minus b, you must understand that you have to take the upper bound of a minus away the lower bound of b. Later, I will show you why this is the case, right? So the upper bound of a is 5.5 minus away the lower bound of b, which is 2.5. And that will give us 3.0. Now, you may wonder why I do not minus the upper bound of b. Instead, I minus it with the lower bound of b. But to show you the reason why, let us do an alternate solution where I will get the upper bound of a minus away the upper bound of b. So in this scenario, I will have 5.5 minus away the upper bound of b, which is 3.5. And my answer will be 2.0. You can see that my 2.0 is less than 3.0. And the reason why this is so is because I subtract away the upper bound of b, and that's why I get a smaller number. If I were to subtract away the lower bound of b instead, I will get a larger number in the end. And that is precisely the reason why I will want to subtract away the lower bound of b. Similarly, to get the lower bound of a minus b, I will have to get the lower bound of a minus away the upper bound of b. And again, I will explain to you subsequently why we want to minus away the upper bound of b. So for now, let us substitute the value 4.5 minus 3.5. And that will give us 1.0. Let us see what will happen if I were to subtract away the lower bound of b. I will get 4.5 minus away 2.5. And my answer is 2.0. Again, my 2.0 is larger than my 1.0. That's why, in order to get the lowest possible value of a minus b, I will have to subtract away the upper bound of b. So lastly, let us present the answer as a statement. A minus b have a lower bound of 1.0 and an upper bound of 3.0. That's it. Now, let us try another example, 2a minus b. So for now, pause the video and give yourself some time to answer this question. After you're done with this question, you may continue to play the video and watch the solution. You may pause the video now. Alright, I hope you have got the solution now. So, in order to get the upper and lower bound of 2a minus b, first of all, I will have to get the upper and the lower bound of a, which is 5.5 and 6.5, and also for b, which is 2.5 and 3.5. So, to get the upper bound of 2a minus b, I will need to have the upper bound of 2a minus away the lower bound of b. and I will have 2 times of 6.5 minus away 2.5, and I will have 10.5. Similarly, to get the lower bound of 2a minus b, I will need to have the lower bound of 2a minus away the upper bound of b, and that will give us 5.5 times 2 minus away 3.5, and that will be 7.5. So now I will write the answer down as a statement. 7.5 as the lower bound and 10.5 as the upper bound. So do you get the correct answer? I hope you do. And if you are not clear about the concept, you may review this video again.